Welcome to Melita's Delicacies. Friends, back again with one more Goan delicacy and surely a monsoon delicacy. As you can see that this is a snake god wine and there are a lot of snake gods or what is commonly called in Goa, the podval or the podvale. It is a highly nutritious vegetable, but not much cooked in the Goan kitchens. Maybe because people don't know the nutritive value of this vegetable or they don't know how to cook it. But today I'm going to show you a very interesting, delicious recipe of this snake god. And I bet you from the day onwards, you would always want to cook the podvale or the snake god this way only. So keep watching till the end so that you do not miss any steps in making a delicious stuffed snake god recipe. So here I have about three snake gods I picked up from the garden, but I'm going to use only two of them. So first you need to wash them and tap them dry. And then just slightly scrape off the peel on the top, just as lightly as you can. You can see it how I'm doing. Lightly you scrape off the skin and then we go ahead. Friends, if you are new to my channel or have not subscribed to my channel as yet, please do subscribe now and don't forget to press the bell icon for notification of my new videos that I upload every week and do watch my shorts too. And do like, share and comment in my channel. So here you see that I am cutting this podvale into smaller pieces, about 3 to 4 inches, not more bigger than that, and preferably cut all the pieces of the same size. And now after cutting, what you have to do is put your knife like this inside and lightly roll it about, and the seeds get removed. It's very easy, but make sure that you do not cut the outer part of the snake god. It's very light. Another important tip in cooking this snake god is that you buy or you pick up when they are nice and tender. I have kept my water for boiling. I'm putting here my steamer and just placing these snake god pieces in it, and I will steam them for about 4 to 5 minutes. And then here I'm sprinkling a little of salt on them so that, you know, they, as they get steamed, they take in the salt, and steam them again for another 2-3 minutes. And then remove them. See, they are ready. If you overcook them, they will break off. So be careful to handle them with a light hand and let them cool. Now take a pan and saute about 1/2 cup of prawns till they change their color, and then remove them from the pan and let them cool for some time. Now take one large onion and one large tomato and saute them till they are half cooked. Then add 1/4 teaspoon of cumin seed and 1 teaspoon of ginger garlic paste and saute till the raw smell of the ginger garlic paste goes. Now add about 2 chilies, depending upon your taste. I'm adding here 1/2 cup of grated carrot and 1/2 cup of grated beetroot. They are not boiled, they're raw. And if you like the combination, you use it. If you don't like, you can just have a mixture of prawns, chili fry and stuff it. Add 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder. Roughly chop the prawns and add to this mixture and cook for about 2 minutes. Now why I had removed the prawns from the pan is that if I had to keep the prawns for so long, Then they would get overcooked and turn rubbery. Add salt to taste. Cover and cook for about 5 minutes. I have not added any water in this vegetable. Just covering and cooking it, they release their own water, and this way the nutritional value of the food that you cook remains intact. Remove off the large pieces of the chili. Mix well. You see the water has almost dried out now. Add roughly chopped coriander and mix well and cook for about 2 minutes so that the water of the coriander that it releases gets evaporated. At this time you cook on a high flame so that the water kind of which is there gets evaporated. Turn off the flame and let it cool. Now those who want to make this dish as a vegetarian, do not add the prawns. Here I have 2 boiled potatoes and I have mashed them. I'm adding 1.5 potato in this mixture and half I'm keeping for a later use. Mix so well that it forms a nice binding. The potatoes will do the work of nice giving it a nice binding. You can use breadcrumbs also, but I prefer using potato for nutritional value. Now let the mixture cool and then you stuff in the mixture. As you stuff in, keep your finger on the other side of the snake gourd piece, otherwise the mixture will fall out. Take a small piece of the mashed potato and place it like this and seal the edge of the snake gourd piece. And do the other side likewise. You see, it is nicely sealed and now the filling will not come out of it. Fill in all the remaining likewise. Friends, snake gourd is very rich in different types of vitamins and minerals, and they are available in this season for a very short time. So make sure that you grab your opportunity of enjoying this nutritional value of the snake gourd and buy these days and eat them as much as you can because they are seasonal. Now heat up a little oil in a pan and place these snake gourd pieces, stuffed snake gourd pieces in the oil, and on low to medium flame fry them on all sides. You just need to be around every 2 minutes or so, you keep turning them and you fry them on all sides. Now snake gourds are already steamed and cooked and the filling is also cooked. We don't need to fry them on high flame. This frying is only to give a nice tied texture and flavor to the dish. I am already feeling very tempted to eat this. So please friends, do try this recipe at home with your family and friends and enjoy. And don't forget to like, share and subscribe to Melita's Delicacies. And keep watching Melita's Delicacies.